Hey, brothers and sisters, this is Brother Patrick. I want to make a quick video of some random information. The Lord has had me looking at videos when the power was on for the last 2 days, all about the Kennedy assassination. I don't know why. Just been watching it. And I found out some things. Some random facts. Lots of random facts. Let me just say what's important. Number one, Billy Graham got a word from the Lord that it was that President Kennedy should not go to Texas. I never heard that before, but it was in the news reports by Walter Cronkite. I watched the coverage as it happened that day. Billy Graham tried to contact President Kennedy and couldn't get through, and tried to warn him, do not go to Dallas, because he had had it in spirit from the Lord. So praise the Lord for that. I never heard that before, and I thank the Lord for that. And it made the national news at that time. The second thing is, of course, the key or link to the New World Order, a link to the Antichrist and all that, is the fact that those people that killed Kennedy are agents of the same God with a small g, i.e., you know, a.k.a. Lucifer, Satan. There's a connection there. That's the same people. The military-industrial complex in the United States, that is arms of Satan's tentacles. I wouldn't say arms, tentacles. Of the Antichrist, of his kingdom, like the Mafia and all that. A Mafia was started by the Illuminati, by a guy named the original Mafia, but the name Mafia and the modern organization we know is La Cosa Nostra, is Mafia, is an acronym in Italian, and the guy's name is Manzini, Giuseppe Manzini. Now Manzini, I'm changing topics, you know, because they say the Mafia was probably involved. Jack Ruby worked for the Mafia. Something else I found out, now that I'm on that topic. William F. Buckley was a CIA agent, documented. He worked in Mexico as a CIA agent. Go look it up. Anderson Cooper, CIA. Al Sharpton, informant for the FBI. All of these guys. Don't you know that this is a matrix? That the same people on TV also work for all those alphabet agencies? That's why when I was in the States, I saw that commercial that the number one TV show was this, the Navy one. What is that? Not CSI. What is that? NCIS. I cannot believe, you know, the indoctrination. It's the number one TV show of the American Navy, you know, investigating and, you know, the militarization of the police and all this stuff's all interconnected. So Manzini, who the Mafia's acronym includes his name, the M of Mafia is Manzini, his name. You can Google all these things, I'm telling you. He lived at the same time as Albert Pike, whose body is in the wall, or his ashes are in the wall up there at the Masonic Temple. You know, it's at whatever it is, 33rd Avenue in Washington, D.C. And old Albert Pike was a contemporary, a Luciferian, who rewrote a lot of Masonic stuff and added a lot to Masonry. Also was a co-founder of the Ku Klux Klan, a former Civil War general, who was also was into bestiality and wrote in his diary about his bestialic whatever escapades in the woods. He channeled Lucifer and wrote that there would be three wars to end humankind as we know it and bring in the kingdom of Lucifer. And the first one, he said, would be the isms or whatever. I don't know. The second one would be the isms. The first one would be dealing with Russia, getting rid of Russia, bringing down the kingdom of Russia, which they did. They did a Bolshevik revolution backed by the war, Big Daddy Warbucks, the Warburger brothers. Anyway, I've already mentioned all that stuff before. Okay, American bankers back, you know, even the Germans, they put linen in a sealed train and sent him with $10 million dollars worth of gold or whatever it is, or 10 million marks from Germany in a sealed train to Russia. You can look up all this stuff. Anyway, Second World War between the isms, which it was, Nazism, fascism, communism, whatever. The Third World War will be between the Muslims, or they called them the Mohammedites, between the Mohammedism people, and the Jews and the Christians, let them kill each other off, and then Antichrist, you know, the Lucifer can come, and everyone will know that Lucifer is really God. I said all these people. So on September the 11th was really even though there's already been going on some, But September the 11th was the big kickoff of this final world war. So we've been in the final world war since September the 11th. Now, brothers and sisters, when September the 11th happened, I had only been baptized in the Holy Spirit about 6 months, and I was just at total peace. I was walking in revival, and I said, hey, maybe America will wake up. I was excited about it, that this could be a change in America, but I soon found out it wasn't true. But in the first week, I was like, hey, you know, this could be great. You know, this could be the best thing that happened to America in the fact that people would come to the Lord. You know what I'm saying? But about a few months after 9/11, the Lord, you know, woke me up in the middle of the night and, you know, gave me, I think it's Matthew 24:6, and, you know, there'll be earthquakes in diverse places, wars and rumors of war and earthquake in diverse places, and, you know, famines and earthquakes. And this is the beginning of sorrows. That's the part that the Lord was quickening in my spirit. This is the beginning of sorrows. 9/11 was the beginning of sorrows. And it's not about the United States, but it's about a world war to bring in the new world order. That's what it's all about. The motto on the back of the dollar bill comes from what they call the Kume Sibyl, which is the channeling of the spirit of Apollo or Apollyon, straight the beast out of the bottomless pit, the captain over those beasts that come out of the bottomless pit. He is the beast. His name is Apollyon, or Abaddon in Hebrew, the destroyer. You know, the son of perdition. That word is Apollonia, same from destroyer, the son of destruction, okay, for the Antichrist. Also, Judas was called the son of perdition, the son of destruction. You know, so the destroyer, Apollyon, a woman channeled his words, like the oracle at Delphi was also channeling that same spirit. The woman with the python spirit that Paul cast the demon out of her, that was also Apollyon, a demon or a voice speaking from the fallen angel Apollyon, again, that Paul cast it out. So anyway, in the book of Acts. So anyway, brothers and sisters, where am I going? Oh, yeah, so on the back of the dollar bill, it says, announcing the new world order. But that whole sentence that comes from one of these poetic utterances given by a woman possessed by a demon or speaking by the spirit of the fallen angel Apollyon, the Kume Sibyl, said, out of chaos, a new world order. It's talking about the return of Apollo. Apollo and Apollyon are synonymous in the ancient world. The return of that spirit. The return of him, Apollo, the Antichrist. That's the spirit of the Antichrist, the destroyer. Out of chaos, a new world order. That's what they're doing. They're making chaos in all the Middle East, all those countries. Everything really in the Bible is about Israel and the countries immediately surrounding Israel. And kingdoms, the dreams of Daniel, the dreams of Nebuchadnezzar, all of those things are about kingdoms that ruled over Israel. Foreign Gentile kingdoms that ruled over Israel. There's been lots of kingdoms in the world, but they didn't rule over Israel. So the center point is Israel and all in the Middle East. Egypt is the second most mentioned country in the Bible after Israel. All those kingdoms around there, Assyria or Syria, all of those people, the Philistines, Palestinians, all those people around there, Edomites, which is also them, the Jordanians, all those people are the people that's talked about in the Bible. That's the center of all this, basically. But the kickoff for this end time stuff was 9/11. So I mentioned in the end of my last video, and I might know which one I'll load first, but the thing is, the Lord had me studying about this JFK thing for 2 days. For like 4 hours, I watched his documentaries about it. And I've seen it before. I remember on the 25th anniversary, when I was in Germany, the 25th anniversary of the John F. Kennedy assassination, there's Armed Forces Network. There's only one English channel before. This is before cable. And they had it 24 hours. They were showing all this stuff all about JFK. And so I watched it at that time. So I knew a lot about it already from that time when I was still a teenager there in the army in Europe, in Germany. But anyway, brothers and sisters, I was looking at all these things I'm talking about. And the point of the Kennedy thing is how it's connected to the New World Order. It's the same people. That's the same people. But, you know, a new generation of the same people. They're following the same spirit. You know, it's just like the church. Satan's people goes on. They have a plot and a plan they've been following for hundreds of years. What unites them? Satan unites them. Lucifer unites them. They're not, they're committed to it by a spiritual thing. You know, just like Christians are committed by the Holy Spirit, by the Word of God, by the Lord. Okay. These are generations of demon worshipers. Luciferians, all those different branches, witchcraft, whatever, Wiccan, Wicca is this ancient name for witchcraft. That's all it is. They changed it to Wicca so people wouldn't persecute them, but it's witchcraft. Same thing. Anyway, brothers and sisters, the Lord was speaking to me about these things, and then I was just led, and I looked. C.S. Lewis died on the same day that John F. Kennedy did. And then the Lord is leading me with a whole new thing, which I'm not going to get into this video, about C.S. Lewis. Not only is the Lord having me looking at about the New World Order and the rise of that and how it's connected to the Kennedy assassination and all these things, but the Lord kicked it off and sent me in a whole new direction from the fact that C.S. Lewis died the same day Kennedy was assassinated. I didn't know that. So that's an odd fact that I would have never thought of. You know what I'm saying? It's like those times the Lord, if you've been watching my videos, the Lord gave me the dates of, in a dream, I heard the date. That it was the end of the, and I looked it up, it's the end of the Communist Empire. The day before, I heard a date and a name, and it was the last, it was the this Ataturk, who was the first ruler of Turkey. But on that date was the end of the Ottoman Empire. In the beginning of, they became a secular democracy. And so this is another time where the Lord has shown me a date. When Kennedy was assassinated, it's also the day that C.S. Lewis died. So it's interconnected, and there's a whole other, like I said, a whole other branch of information that the Lord is leading me on. So it's pretty wild, and I thank the Lord for that. And I'll be back with that one after I get a chance to look at that and go over exactly what it is the Lord wants me to understand about C.S. Lewis and the things he wrote and how it's related to all this stuff to the end times, brothers and sisters. But anyway, brothers and sisters, God bless you. I could go. There's some more information. Oh, yeah, here. I'm just going to throw this on there. This is, I don't know that this is related, but it is related to the return of the Nephilim, the fallen angels, return of Apollo, the fallen angel who will either himself appear as a man like they did, you know, angels can do in the Bible, they appear as men, and be the Antichrist, or he will possess a man, and that will be the Antichrist, possessed by the destroyer, Apollo. But listen to this. If you take Washington, D.C., Philadelphia, all up there, to Boston, brothers and sisters. Did you know that you can draw a straight line from Washington, D.C. through Baltimore, Philadelphia, and Boston? And it's all in one straight line, brothers and sisters. And it's also on one of those ley lines, L-E-Y lines, these magnetic fields of the earth, okay? Number two, when you draw a line from Washington, D.C. through those cities, it passes right through the middle of Stonehenge. Now, I know there's videos I saw a long time ago, a year or two ago when I was studying all this stuff, how on the whole world, all these megalithic sites are interrelated on these ley lines, these energy fields. But I just want to say this about those things. All of that wisdom that you hear, you know, the pyramid was some kind of power source and all this, and, you know, this is something you might not have heard before either. Remember when everybody keeps hearing all these sounds and stuff around the earth? Actually, someone did an experiment and did a noise, like whatever, inside the pyramids. They did some kind of experiment in the pyramid, and the Great Pyramid makes a noise just like what people keep hearing around the world. Now, I want to say this. The secular people and people that are atheists and whatever and all this, they're into this and say, oh, we could tap into this ancient wisdom and all that. Of course, that's what the American Defense Department is trying to do, what DARPA and all them are trying to do. They're trying to tap into these ancient energy sources. They want to bring back the DNA of the Nephilim and all this wacky stuff that's unbelievable. They want to do that. Mix the DNA of a monkey and a chicken, everything else, make super soldiers and whatever technology they can advance, you know, to make war. It's always about making war. But brothers and sisters, this is what I want to tell you about that as a Christian. That information is real. That information originally came from God. The fallen angels who slept with the daughters of men, it tells us in an extra biblical text that they taught the human people how to do all that. They taught Tubal Cain, who's in the Bible, how to make this metal working. They taught people how to do, you know, to make witchcraft and make herbs and make potions and love potions and all that kind of stuff. They taught them all this wisdom that they got from God, which is really from God. But God didn't want mankind to know how to do all that stuff. In other words, do you think God wanted people making nuclear bombs and blowing each other up? No. Of course God doesn't want us to do those things. So that's why God made the garden, and that's why when we live on this earth, just like now, you know, some little kid could go around and start yelling, hell, Satan, and try to, you know, conjure up Satan. But God's not going to let some little kid do that. God child-proofs his house. You know what I'm saying? And so when we do stuff in ignorance, God tries to protect us. That's a whole other sermon I'm getting into. Let me just say this. Sin is sin, not because God is a killjoy and God doesn't want people to have a good time. Sin is sin because sin is hurtful. As an example, getting divorced. It hurts people. It hurts the children. It hurts everybody. It hurt, you know, that's why it's a sin. As an example, doing drugs, getting high, losing control of your mind, getting out of your mind is a sin. Why? God doesn't want you to have a good time and party and get high? No. It's not because God doesn't want you to have a good time. It's just that when you do drugs, you might go out and get in a car and run over somebody and kill them. Or, you know, you lose your mind, you might, you know, go on a bad trip and get a knife and kill everybody. I mean, those things happen. You know, you become a different person. You open yourself up to demon possession. All kinds of stuff you could talk about. But let me say this again for those who are watching my videos who are nervous people. I have several nervous viewers. I will say this. Of course, if we repent, 1 John 1:9 says, if we confess our sins, God is just and faithful to forgive us of our sins and cleanse us of all unrighteousness. Okay, so we've all sinned. Lots of people watching this video have done drugs. Lots of people have been divorced. Lots of people have been alcoholics, you know, gotten drunk, carried on a bunch of foolishness, maybe even had a DWI, maybe been arrested, maybe you got drunk and beat somebody up. You've been on the receiving end of spousal abuse, or you've been the abuser, whatever, you know, all those things. Yeah, and I'm saying that those things can be forgiven, but that's not the point of this video. I have to say that because I know the mind of lots of people who watch my videos. Let me say this. Let's see a nice way to say this. Don't keep thinking about yourself and everything about you. Think about how it relates to everybody else in the body of Christ. As I've told many times, use the acronym JOY. If you want to have joy, have Jesus first, others second, yourself last. Most people have them yourself first, others second, Jesus last. That's why you don't have joy. You got to spell it that way. So think about the Lord first, others and yourself last. If you've repented, you've been forgiven, okay, move on. But let's talk about the topic of what you did in the past, what I did in the past, how it relates to other people, and the reason why God doesn't want us to do it. Sin is sin. It's wrong. It's bad. God doesn't like it, but we can be forgiven if we repent. We're washed clean by the blood of the Lamb. Though our sins be as scarlet, they shall become white as snow. Isaiah chapter 1. By the blood of Jesus. Anyway, brothers and sisters, let me cut it off. I'm running on all these different topics. I just wanted to get all this stuff out here, some of the things the Lord showed me, all these different topics, all related, though, to the end times. God bless.